take the bomb.
So let's take a look at the venues of this Universiade. Val di Fiemme would host the Nordic skiing competitions. It would be Basilia di Pine for the speed skating events. Val di Fassa will host the alpine skiing. And Monte Baldoni, the venue for all the snowboarding, as well as the freestyle skiing. Pergine will be the arena for curling and ice hockey. Another venue for the ice hockey, the Gian Mario Scola Arena in Alba di Canazei. The men's tournament taking place here, one of the major events of the games. 12 teams divided into three groups of four, and to launch the competition, a big game between the USA and Sweden. Team USA starting its offense with a goal by Christopher Joseph in the final 3 minutes of the first period. The game remaining tight until the third period, when the Americans were finally able to seal it with just a few seconds remaining. The man to do the damage, Bobby Baudet. Team USA finally defeating Sweden then 2-0. Now, ice hockey, not a sport that most would associate with Great Britain. The British squad making its return to the Winter Universiade for the first time since Turin 2007.
You peel off, that's your guy.
All right. We're a team picked from all around the country. So there's players right from Scotland. I come from a team that plays in Wales. And there's a bunch of guys coming from teams that play in England. And what we do is we try and get together at a central location in England for our training sessions in Nottingham.
But it would not be an easy comeback for them. Russia against Great Britain, perhaps one of the most one-sided matches of the tournament. Russia, a major nation, of course, in ice hockey. And the British really quite inexperienced. Initially holding the Russians off. The first goal, though, coming from Podzhenyalov. Just one more in the first period, but in the second and third periods, well, they just kept coming. Final score, Russia 8, Great Britain 0. Slovakia against the Czech Republic, a tough match this between two classic ice hockey powerhouses. Slovakia scoring first, but the Czechs coming back, and at 2-2, the game went into overtime. But everything finally decided with the game-winning shot from Martin Kalinak for Slovakia. Basilia di Pine, 1 hour from Trento, all set for the speed skating. And this 26-year-old Martina Sablikova, the undisputed star of this 26th Winter Universiade. The long-distance specialist came to Trento with a 2 Olympic golds won in Vancouver and 10 world titles. For the Czech champion, the Winter University Games, a step on the road to the Sochi Olympics, and she would win comfortably in the 3,000 and the 5,000 meters. But while Sablikova flew the flag for the Czech Republic, the really strong nation of speed skating was South Korea. They took 15 of the 36 medals at stake. The South Koreans would win all the team events. And amazingly, they took all three medals in the women's 500 meters. The only race that totally escaped the South Korean influence was the men's 1,000 meters. After two silvers in the 500 and the 1500, the Italian Mirko Giacomo Nenzi was the winner. He'd get a fourth medal of bronze with the Italian team in the pursuit. Meanwhile, the Dutch may be the traditional superpowers of speed skating, but in Trentino, they came away with just one gold. Espina Casimir took the 10,000 meters. In figure skating, the Asians arrived in force. In the men's individual, Japan's Akio Sasaki took third place, silver for Russia's Gordei Goshkov, and 23-year-old Nan Song scored a first gold for China. A On the other hand, the Russians remained untouchable in pairs. They took the first two places ahead of the Italians. The winners, Ksenia Stolbova and Fedor Klimov. Second, Evgenia Tarasova and Vladimir Morozov. Nicole Della Monica and Matteo Guarisse taking the bronze. In curling, 10 teams took part in the women's competition. Japan, Switzerland, the USA, Sweden, South Korea, China, Italy, Canada, and Great Britain, plus the hosts, Russia. And the experienced Russians were the winners, beating South Korea. The Swiss were third. The same nations fought for the men's title, except for Japan and Russia, who were replaced by Norway and the Czech Republic. Sweden is a powerful force in curling. They have an academy back home where their promising teenagers are groomed for the game. And it was the Swedes who came out on top, skipped by Oscar Eriksson. The silver going to Britain, Canada taking the bronze. This was one of the most notable events of the Universiade. Hungary against the odds in short track speed skating. In the 5,000 meters relay, they beat the Canadians in the final, the Russians finishing third, the only short track event that wasn't dominated by the Koreans and the Chinese. One after another, the two Asian giants shared the spoils. Three victories for China, four for Korea. And all in all, between them, they won 14 of the 24 medals. Back in Pergine. She was 19 years of age, a student at the University of Moscow. Sofia Birgyukova brought Russia its second title in figure skating. Valentina Marche of Italy and another Russian skater, Sofia Mishina, would join Sofia on the podium. And the fourth and final event, the dance. It's been a French speciality in recent years, and so it was again. Victory for Pernell Caron and Lloyd Jones, ahead of Yulia Zlobina and Alexei Sitnikov of Azerbaijan. With the bronze going to the Russians, Victoria Sinitsina and Ruslan Zhigansin. With a total of two golds and six other medals, Russia remained the great power in university games figure skating.